Fertility treatments like Clomid or Follistim can increase the chance for pregnancy complications because they increase the chance for having a multiple pregnancy. But what if a couple with infertility gets pregnant on their own without any treatment? Are they still at greater risk? Check it out on today's episode of Infertility TV. First, the way to figure out whether infertility itself is associated with a higher rate of complications is to compare couples who have had problems getting pregnant but did eventually conceive on their own to couples who did not have any trouble getting pregnant. One of the earliest studies to look at this was published 20 years ago. Couples who expressed concern about the length of time it took to get pregnant were 40% more likely to deliver a baby that had very low birth weight compared to couples who were not worried about the time it took. Babies with very low birth weight are more likely to experience a variety of health problems, some very serious. Perinatal mortality is defined as the death of a fetus after the 20th week of pregnancy and up to 28 days after birth. A study of over 60,000 births concluded that women with untreated infertility were over 3 times more likely to lose a fetus or baby in the perinatal period compared to women without infertility. Another study compared couples who took less than 3 months to conceive to couples that took over a year to conceive, but who did so without any treatment. And they found that couples who took a long time were over 3 times more likely to lose a baby in the first month after birth. In another study, infertile couples had a higher rate of preterm labor, pre-eclampsia, which is a high blood pressure problem in pregnancy, infection of the placenta, and cesarean section. Children were 30% more likely to be admitted to a neonatal intensive care unit. It also turns out that lots of other problems can occur in the babies of parents with infertility long after the pregnancy is over. The children of infertile couples had a 3-fold higher incidence of severe outcomes such as cerebral palsy, mental retardation, autism, seizure disorders, or cancer by 6 years of age. These children also had a 40% increase in moderate adverse outcomes such as attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, attention deficit disorder, learning disabilities, behavior disorders, developmental delay, serious vision disorders, and serious hearing disorders. For more information about infertility, check out this playlist. If you have a topic you would like us to cover in a future episode of Infertility TV, put it in the comments. If you like this video, then please like this video. Subscribe now. Infertility TV produces a new video each week. It's like having a fertility specialist in your phone.